Energetics of glycolysis. Glycolysis means breakdown of glucose into two simple compounds. So they are pyruvic acid. Here, one glucose molecule is converted into two pyruvic acid molecule. During that period, during the pathway, there is a energy is released. So how much of energy is released and how much of energy is required for glycolysis and what is the net energy is left. So we can calculate now. So during the glycolysis, how many NADH2s are produced? The produced NADH2s are produced NADH plus H plus R. How many? Two. One NADH2 is involved in the electron transportation, involved in the oxidative phosphorylation, that is releases to two ATPs, one NADPH2, when in oxidative oxidative phosphorylation, there it resulted to two ATPs. So how many ATPs? 2 into 2. So they are 4 ATPs are released from NADH+. And here, how many ATPs are released? It means substrate level of phosphorylation. How many ATPs are released? Means here, 2 plus 2 ATPs, 4 ATPs are released. So the number are 4. So it means the released ATPs are released ATPs during the glycolysis. If one molecule of glucose partially oxidized, so that resulted to how many ATPs? 4 ATPs. So totally how many ATPs are released here? 8 ATPs are released. So total release of ATPs are 8. But how many are required for glycolysis means required ATPs or needed ATPs are how many? 2. At the first reaction and third reaction of glycolysis, the 2 ATPs are utilized. So utilized ATPs are 2. So what are the net ATPs? 6 ATPs are net ATPs. Net gain are net. Net ATPs are resulted to 6 ATPs. So how you can explain this means one molecule of glucose involved in glycolysis or partial oxidation that yields to 6 ATP of energy. And also you write as glucose NAD plus. So how many NADs? 2 NAD plus and 4 ADP plus PI. How many? 4 PI. That gives rise to 2 pyruvic acid molecules as well as 2 NADHH+ and 4 ATPs are released. So this is the summary reaction of glycolysis. So during the glycolysis, here the glucose is hexose sugar. So the hexo sugar is converted into trio sugars, so trio acids. It means three carbon consisting acids, so they are pyruvic acids.